Which of the following carbocations is likely to rearrange? To approach solving this problem, we need to understand that a carbocation will rearrange if it can become more stable. So we need to remember our stability trends for carbocations. Like alkenes, they are stabilized by the presence of alkyl groups on the adjacent carbon atoms. And so if our carbocations are more substituted, they are more stable. The trend that we have learned is that a tertiary carbocation is more stable than a secondary carbocation, which is more stable than a primary carbocation. So we first need to look at each of these carbocations and decide how they are substituted. If we look at the first one, we see bonds to two other carbon atoms, meaning that this is a secondary carbocation. Looking at the second one, we see also two bonds, one, two, to other carbon atoms, so this is also a secondary carbocation. In C, the carbocation has bonds to one, two, three other carbons, so this is a tertiary cation. And finally, in D, we have a carbocation that has bonds to one, two other carbons, so this is also a secondary carbocation. So the tertiary cation is already as stable as it can be. That will not rearrange. In looking at the secondary carbocations, what we want to look for is if we have a group on a next door atom that can shift to make it into a more stable tertiary carbocation. What we've seen that can shift are alkyl groups or hydrogens. If we look at the first one, a shift of a hydrogen atom would just give us another secondary carbocation. That's not likely to occur. If we look at B, on the adjacent carbon atom, we have a couple methyl groups. If we were to do a methyl shift here, so we would move this bond, this would give us the following structure. In moving this bond, we're taking electrons away from this atom right here, which means our positive charge would then be here, making this a tertiary carbocation. This is our carbocation that is most likely to rearrange.